So, and my most super funnest thing, wet and messy. Okay? So, wet and messy activities. We've got two per month, and they're not really theme related. This one just happens to be. So this is animals in water. Everybody has a different way, a different sensory bucket. Obviously, for purposes here, I just grabbed it with the bucket. And the other activity for this month was animals in sand. So, but we've got really, really fun, cool activities. Obviously, sensory experiences are how infants relate to the world. Touch, taste, smell, feel, everything is just, they just get ooey and gooey. As a world-class leader in education, these are experiences we need to offer our infants. These are things that parents are definitely not offering their children at home. And again, as an infant classroom, this is how they learn, and we are not, again, they're not having things that they take home and put up on walls. So these are our photo op moments, and again, we all have that teacher when they do these things in the classroom. Our teachers are proud when they have these wet and messy activities. They might be few and far between right now, but how many of you guys, when the teachers do this, they call you down the hallway, look at what I did! But it's usually something where they've used like all of your red food coloring and they've just stained your floor or the children. And, you know, or they've used up all your chocolate pudding or something, but now you can plan for it, okay? So now this is really great. So we've got, you know, they're squishing Jell-O or playing with the pasta or the cornstarch, and we've got some soft ones too, or they're ripping paper. We've got, there's one where they're squishing the wet paper in the water, and, you know, and they're stomping on sponges. And so they're doing different wet messes inside a box and painting it. So there's things that you can start planning for, so you don't walk in and go, is that green paint all over my carpet? So, you know, but they're really fun things that are really exciting, and they're ways and opportunities for children to explore their senses and get creative and take these pictures, and they're really cute moments for parents. So when they come home with that little blue finger paint under their nails, parents go, oh, what did you want to do today? You know? It teaches our parents how much they're learning, too. Oh, and it does all these wonderful things for brain development. And so we're teaching our parents. The teachers are having fun, and they're proud of what they're doing. And there's ways to plan for it, too. And the last group, somebody said they're calling it Wet and Messy Wednesday. So the parents make sure they send them in not their best clothes that day. Yeah. I know. I love it. So but that way you can go ahead and start buying tarps now. so, yeah.